A large amount of pesticides are being currently used in vegetables and fruits to prevent the attack of insects and weeds. However, contamination of pesticides in fruits and vegetables beyond the tolerance limit is a matter of great concern. Overuse of pesticides has adverse effects on human health and on the environment. The application of pesticides, beside contaminating the air, water, and soil at the source, have caused extended damage to our ecosystem. For example, excessive use of pesticides has resulted in the declining health of pollinators such as bees and butterflies. Indian Institute of Science Education and Research, Thiruvananthapuram, in collaboration with Kerala Agricultural University, has developed a surface-enhanced Raman spectroscopy-based device for the detection of organophosphate pesticides and pyrethroid insecticides in fruits and vegetables.
This project is funded by the Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India, and the Department of Science and Technology, Government of India. In this project, we have adopted a modern spectroscopy technique, namely surface enhanced Raman spectroscopy, for the rapid detection of pesticide residues in fruits and vegetables.
So whatever be the type of pesticide, it has to be fully extracted. That is, the maximum recovery of the pesticide should be possible by the extraction method, with minimum time as well as with the maximum efficiency, that is almost 100% recovery of the pesticide, by avoiding most of the pigments like chlorophyll, xanthophyll, carotenoids, etc.
The second aspect is the design of plasmonic platform. Our group has fabricated plasmonic platform which can detect picomolar quantities of pesticide residues from fruits and vegetables.
Surface enhanced Raman spectroscopy, or SERS, is a solution to the problem of multi-residue pesticide detection at trace levels.
Raman spectroscopy is named in the honor of its inventor, C.V. Raman, an Indian physicist who was awarded the Nobel Prize in the year 1930 for his pioneering work on the discovery of Raman effect. It is based on inelastic scattering of the incident radiation during the light-matter interaction, that is, by analyzing the scattered light having frequency different from that of the incident light. Raman spectrum is the fingerprint of a molecule, and hence Raman spectroscopy is extremely useful for finding the chemical identities of molecules. The sensitivity of intrinsically weak Raman scattering can be enhanced to single molecule level using surface enhanced Raman spectroscopy.
We have developed a method for printing various plasmonic nanoparticles on paper substrates, thus creating SCRS platforms.
Paper substrates provide high specific area and are compatible for large scale printing approaches and require smaller sample volume, can be easily disposed and are more cost effective.
My colleagues from ISO Thiruvananthapuram have made substantial contribution to this project. The theoretical insight for the design of plasmonic platform is provided by Dr. R. S. Swati from the School of Chemistry, and the signal processing and data comparison algorithms are developed by Dr. Alin Shaji from the School of Physics and Dr. Sheetal and Dr. Arun from the School of Mathematics. This provides a pass-fail output depending on the total pesticide insecticide content in the sample.
And the plasmonic platforms are interfaced with a benchtop Raman spectrometer assembled with the assistance of Professor Chandrabas from the Jawaharlal Nehru Center for Advanced Scientific Research, Bangalore.
This is a benchtop Raman spectrometer designed for detecting the Raman scatter from pesticides. Our source light is a 632 nanometer laser. The spectrometer is from Ocean Optics and it is designed specifically for a 632 nanometer laser. This Raman scatter from the SERS substrate, it collected via the objective to a series of optics and is collected by a collecting lens here and to the spectrometer.
The algorithms developed at IISER Thiruvananthapuram are being interfaced with the benchtop Raman spectrometer and a commercially purchased handheld device. The device will provide a pass-fail output depending on the total pesticide insecticide content. This will permit the rapid on-site quantification of pesticide insecticide residue in fruits, vegetables during its production, transportation and marketing by various regulatory authorities.
There's a lot of investment in ISIS from the government with taxpayers' money. I sincerely wish that this technology will be taken forward by the government to the benefit of the people.